Some industries, including fire, oil, and military, may opt to use the industrial wrist seal because of its durability. Before installing the industrial wrist seal, the regular wrist seal and wrist support pad must be removed. First, disconnect the hand pod from the hoses by pressing the quick release buttons on the connectors. Grasp the wrist seal from around the midsection of the hand pod and pull towards the end of the hand pod. Push the wrist support pad to the narrow end of the hand pod where the hoses normally attach. Take the industrial wrist seal and identify the tapered panel. Align the wide side of the tapered panel with the bottom of the hand pod. Stretch the neoprene over the pod to create the seal. Pull the wrist seal onto the pod so that the ends of the ribs overlap the pod by about 1 inch. Ensure that the rubber side of the neoprene is flat against the pod. Ensure that the hand support pad is in place beneath the perfusion pad. To use CoreControl, insert the hand into the open end of the pod. Those with smaller wrists can insert the hand until the fingertips touch the end of the pod. Then, pull back slightly to unfold the neoprene and create the seal. Those with larger wrists may have to stretch the neoprene over their arm and flatten it so that the rubber side is in contact with the skin. Both must ensure that the palm is in full contact with the perfusion pad and passively rest the palm during cooling. When the unit is turned on, it will evacuate the extra air. The wrist seal will collapse and become snug around the wrist. If the wrist seal does not collapse, reposition the wrist seal to ensure that the rubber side of the neoprene is in full contact with the pod and the forearm. To remove the hand, turn the power off. Pull the wrist seal away from the arm to break the vacuum and remove hand.